Hey guys, what is up? The NeoCubest here. Welcome to episode 16 of my Minecraft Hardcore Survival Let's Play. So, in between last episode and this one, there's been a lot of time, and I've had a lot of time to do a lot of fun stuff. There was a live stream last night, and if you missed it, it's uploaded on my channel. You can find it in the Hardcore playlist. But all we did was do some mining. Now, this isn't everything that we got from just that live stream. This is everything we've gotten pretty much so far. We did get like 23 diamond ore last night on the live stream, so I feel like those live streams are okay because the only thing you miss is me doing a little bit of just mining. I just mined out this big old area and did a tiny bit of strip mining, but I figured on camera we'd at least show what we got from the live stream. This is a super exciting weekend, guys. I have some really fun stuff planned, but let's see what we get. Oh my god, please tell me it's a stack, dude. Please tell me it's... Yes, dude. We have over a stack of diamonds. I don't think... There's only a few times in Minecraft that I've ever had over a stack of diamonds. Like, a few times maybe ever. Awesome. But yes, this is all the stuff we got. All right, so I did also do something last night, which I actually stayed up the entire night to do, and I'll show it off in just a second, but it has to do with slimes. As you could tell, I marked off all of the boundaries of where the slimes are. I'm trying to grab all the iron out of here because we need to make a bunch of iron golems. But basically, I wanted to make a slime farm. And the reason I wanted to make a slime farm is I want to make... you guys know what an ant farm is? Like those little ones you'd put in your room with that gel inside of them. Well, we don't have a blue gel, but we have a green gel. And it's slime blocks. And I want to make an ant farm village that we can use to trade. And I don't know where I got this idea. I just feel like I've seen, you know, ant farm survival used to be something a long, long time ago. It was a custom map, maybe back in 2013. I don't know. It was a long time ago. I remember Ant Venom or Skydas Minecraft playing it and thinking, wow, that was really cool. So I've always wanted to do something with an ant farm style, and I'm going to actually make an ant farm village. So it's going to be interesting. Definitely. We're not going to complete it in this episode. Make some glass tunnels. We'll leave that down just for inspiration, but we're going to go up here. I think I had some iron that I'd grabbed to test some iron golems with, but I think there's still a bunch of iron in here, and we're probably going to need most of it. We're not going to need, like, all of it, but we're probably going to need most of it. I love we have five diamond ore in here just from mining. That's the beauty of mining with Silk Touch, is I love being able to get the diamond ore because it's kind of cool. Like, you never really have diamond ore. Like, you know what I mean? But when you have Silk Touch, you can just grab it whenever. Let's just grab these diamonds out. How many was that? 9? That's fine with me. So we have 16 diamonds plus a stack. We have a ton of emerald ore as well. So we can do something pretty cool in the future. We obviously have enough diamonds now. It's going to be time to get netherite somewhat soon. And then I want to get netherite gear and then beat the game. I know a lot of people probably don't get netherite before beating the game, but I really don't want to die. And I really want feather falling on my boots. My armor is absolutely wrecked. But yeah, the live stream was pretty exciting. You guys should go back and check it out if you want to. It's like 2 hours long, so if you want some extra content, you can watch me mine around for a good bit. That's right. I had already grabbed a little bit of the iron out of those chests to make a few iron blocks to test this farm. That farm took me like 3.5 or 4 hours to make. So I worked until like, I don't know, like 6 or 7 in the morning just to make it because I didn't want to make it on camera because it's just a lot of digging. I had to dig up an entire chunk to the surface. And while I don't like, you know, having you guys miss content like that, I don't think that's really content. That's me digging a hole for like 4 hours. The platforms, I guess, were something I regret missing. But oh, I need to put this iron in here. Hold on. In the actual blast furnace. I realize I have all this ore still. We still have one. There we go. 3 diamonds from that. Not bad at all. You can see I did accidentally kill a golem when I was doing this testing. These slime farms, I've watched so many videos and I decided on the best design that I personally could find. One thing I also want to do is go gold hunting because I want to make a bunch of golden apples, which means we have to enchant a diamond hoe and hopefully get fortune 3 on it. But as you can tell, I have 65 levels, and the reason I have so many levels is, again, during the Zoom classes this week, as well as mining out that little quarry, I actually did a lot of XP farming as well. But I'm beginning to think this slime farm may be a better XP farm. You can see where you set to get the XP, so we'll head over there and I'll show you guys that. But this thing is, like, I can't explain. I think it's about 3,000 plus slime balls per hour. How many double chests is that? I don't know. How we're going to set up a collection system yet, I don't know, but that's the fun of this video. We're gonna hopefully get the slime farm completely finished. I realize now I need to make some sort of path to get over there, because it's just kind of a pain having to scale a mountain every time you want to get over there. There is a hole that I made with a ladder, so I may use that a few times. I don't know why I'm going up the mountain, but it's actually pretty close to the base, which is nice. But yeah, I've never had a slime farm in Minecraft before, and I really wanted to go big or go home on this. And, well, we went big. We did not go home. But, dude, it's just crazy. I can't wait to show you guys how quickly it works. Like, and all the caves I had to light up around this to make this thing work, it was just, it was a lot. But yes, I don't think you guys wanted to see me dig this out. I really don't, genuinely. I think that would have been a little bit boring. But basically, there's a bunch of spawn platforms in there. And of course, we're going to have to go in there to add the iron golems in a second. But let me meet you guys all the way up here. Hopefully, I do not fall because, well, you can see slimes are... Oh, okay, you can see slimes down in there, maybe. I don't know. You could... Oh, there you go. You can see him down there. Oh, that one died. But yes, up here is where you sit. You just sit here and AFK. And it should be pretty safe. I may end up putting a trapdoor right here. But this is all glass, and this is the bottom half of a slab, so nothing can spawn up here. But let me sit up here for like a minute or two, and then we'll go down there and check how many slimes are in the spawner. All right, we're going to head down now, and I can assure you guys, this thing... I've never built a farm that's this efficient before. I'll just put it that way. The ladder is right here. This is how you get all the way up to the top, so let me meet you guys at the bottom of this. I can't cheat this ladder. I have to go all the way down it. You guys hear that? You hear the slime? Oh, yeah. It's slime time, guys. It's slime time. I feel like we're on Nickelodeon here with all the slime. I don't know if they still do slime on Nickelodeon or not. But yeah, you can see I marked all the chunk boundaries out, and it took quite a while to figure out where they were with the coordinates, but you can divide by 16 or something and find it. I don't know. It took me forever. But yeah, this one was a slime chunk, and I filled it in with slabs. This one over here next to where I'm building is also a slime chunk. I filled it with water. That one's a slime chunk. It's filled with water. Don't worry, mobs can't spawn there. Smelt way more iron for golems. Done. Hi, this is Stayed Up All Night Neo. I made a tiny little slime farm. Uh-huh. Tiny, huh? Okay. Rip sleep schedule and do it for the fans. Repair your armor and show off what you got in the live stream. Okay, well, we did show off that. These are some of the materials I think I'm going to need to finish this out. I'm not exactly sure. I know I'm going to need to grab the fence. I know I'm going to need to grab the carved pumpkins. And then these iron blocks, I had to test it. So we have quite a bit of iron blocks. I don't know if it's going to be enough. Hopefully it is. But it's definitely going to be interesting trying to get in here and not dying. So let's just go in and check it out. You guys have not gotten to see the slime farm yet. But yeah. You can see there's quite a few slimes. There is still this little construction ladder in here. Hopefully there's no slimes here, but it's pretty efficient, guys. That was like literally 1 minute. So the reason that there's iron golems here is that the slimes are actually attracted to the iron golems. So on each side of this thing right here, what we're going to have to do, it's pretty simple, really. All you have to do is just dig back like 3 blocks like this, right? You put a torch. And then you put some fence down, and then you build an iron golem just like that, and boop, there you go. Done. So I'm going to have to do this for every layer. Again, a lot of this was just super repetitious, and I didn't feel like it's a very good content to record, unless repetitious is your thing. But I'll time-lapse doing this. I'm going to have to do it on every single layer. Hopefully there's no more slimes just kind of chilling out here. But yeah, every single layer has to have this. I don't really know... Maybe I should have built that one more block down. Let me see here. Because again, I don't have this like done completely. Obviously, there's still a little bit left to do. Yeah, if I have this in line, I guess that one will have to be one block up. I think it should be okay. It's just the problem I'm seeing is what about for the next layer? Yeah, we're going to start at one block down. So again, it's just a ton of little stuff. But let me bring these guys both down by one, and then I'll show you what it looks like. I think what I'm going to do is just do this. And then put the fence down, and then I'll get in there. Yeah, that should be good. Okay, let me do it, and I'll show you what it looks like. So as I was bringing this one down, I realized now that I need to go down in here. I put an iron block there. Man, there's so many slimes. I mean, you guys can hear it, but it's just insane how well this thing works. I need to go grab some stone. 1 second. As you guys may have not noticed, or may have noticed, I made this chest area huge. Because there's just so many materials now. We've been gathering so much stone. We just... It's just, things have been crazy, guys. This world is coming along very, very nicely. This may turn out to be my best world ever. The fact that it's on hardcore is somewhat intimidating. I don't think I'm just going to randomly die, though, so I'm not too worried. But it's definitely a little bit unnerving, I'll admit, because knowing I could lose all this pretty easily, not the most comfortable thought. But yes, let me lower both of these. I figured I'd just tell you I have to come on the outside of the spawner and expand upon this thing. This was built for the first iron golem because, well, it would have fallen out otherwise. So just have to make sure it's nice and expanded. Okay, let me complete it. And by the way, I will remove all these chunk boundaries eventually. Again, I was just trying to identify which slime chunks were here, because slimes were spawning, but they weren't spawning at a very high rate, so I basically just had to figure it out. I know I said I'd come back when I'm done, but look, all I was doing this so I could break these out. And there is an iron block in there, and like, normally I wouldn't be so concerned, but an iron block is kind of a big deal. There we go. Oh my goodness. There's so many slimes, dude. They're going ham down there. Okay. There we go. We don't need the ceiling to be that high either. He can be a little bit more cramped in there. That's fine. There we go. And then we can put a torch down. We can put it. Got to get one block closer. We can put a torch down. Oh, it's because his head is in the way. Move. You know what? Fine. That one will just be like that. Okay. And now we can build the next one. And I think, let's see if this made it a little bit easier. Yeah. Okay. And then what about the next one? That's the only thing is, like, I hadn't figured this part out, so I figured it'd be kind of fun to do on camera. Yeah, you know what? It's going to be a little bit off once we get to the top, but you know what? It's close enough. Again, they attract in like a 16 block radius or something like that. You know, I don't even know if this layer will work, but you know what? We're just going to go all the way to the top with it. I'm not too concerned. If it isn't perfect, it isn't perfect, but it's gonna be better than not having a slime farm. How about that? It seems like the layer under this one might be a little bit off, but again, whatever. Not a big deal. I feel like that's still going to attract the ones on this layer, right? If there's an iron golem like right here, yeah, we should be fine. Okay. Well, let me finish this out. It's going to take quite a bit. I'll time-lapse it, I guess. So give me a little bit. Alright guys, so as you could tell, I did finish one side. We're going to do the other side off camera because it just takes a good bit. Even with the time lapse, it's just kind of a tedious thing. But as you can see, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 iron golems. So it does take a good bit of iron. I think we're going to have enough, and if not, we can go and grab more. But yeah, this thing is going to be hyper efficient. I don't know that we necessarily need 3,000 slime blocks an hour. We're not making like a giant ant farm village, but I figured, I don't know. I just really wanted to do something with all these slimes. They're just so slimy. Okay, well let me, I'm not funny. Let me do this entire thing off camera, because again, it's just gonna take forever. So give me a little bit. All right, well I figured I'd do the last one on camera. It is night, which severely diminishes the amount of mobs that will actually spawn. So this mob spawner is pretty much ineffective at night just because the mob cap gets reached very quickly. But once it turns day, this thing gets to be a little bit hectic. I'm also standing inside of it, so mobs don't really spawn. That's why I have that spawn platform above, because mobs spawn in a 128 block radius sphere around you. I think radius is how you describe a sphere's diameter sphere. I don't know. Either way, 128 block in like a circle around you. or a sphere, I guess. Sorry. But there we go. That's the last one. All of these are complete. Now we just have to build a way to kill them, which I probably should have done before, but we do not any longer need this ladder. So I also don't have any slabs with me. So let me go back down here. Let me grab a few extra slabs. And yeah, I'm pretty proud of this thing. I'm glad we made the pumpkin farm, right? I mean, the pumpkins are super helpful. This is like the most efficient way to light up the farm. We still do have a few slabs. Okay, good. All right, let me go back in and let me fill in all these platforms and just destroy this entire ladder. Now, one thing I didn't show you guys that I also made off camera was this axe. It's called the Pumpkin Crusher. It has efficiency 5 on it, which literally mines pumpkins. Like, you know how you mine netherrack with really high efficiency, how it's like instant? Look, it mines pumpkins like that fast. So it's super helpful, especially for breaking down this ladder. I realize now that it's not going to take that long at all. I thought it was going to be a painful process, but nope. Okay, so we need to devise a way to kill these slimes because they're really annoying me. They're like super duper loud. We also have slabs on this bottom half here just so things do not spawn and disrupt us. But let's go over into here and kill all these guys real quick because they're super annoying. Come on, guys. Meet your maker time. Come on. Come on. Jeez. Maybe we don't even need a way to kill them. We'll just come in here and kill them all. But I don't think you guys realize now that I have these iron golems, there's going to be so many in here. It's going to be unseemly. It's just going to be, it's going to be literally insane. Oh, and there's that iron block I dropped. Good. I'm glad I got that. I thought it was gone forever. Okay. So basically, I don't know exactly how I'm going to pick up all the drops. I'm going to use campfires. I've already made like 2.5 stacks or something like that of campfires that we're going to be using to destroy the slimes. And then beyond that, I don't really have a plan for how I'm going to collect the drops. I know maybe a hopper minecart. I've made a couple hopper minecarts. Sorry, hold on. There's so many of these guys. Jeez, we're going to have like over a stack from just killing this one little area of them. I see a little area of them. It's like a giant clump. There's so many slimes. I didn't know this, but slimes are actually the dumbest mob in the game. Like, there's like a hierarchy of how smart mobs are with their AI. And these guys have no pathfinding. They have nothing. They just jump towards players whenever they're near them. That's literally all they do. Okay, so the one thing I did want to test was, can you collect... I have some hoppers... And where are the rest of my campfires? Oh, there they are. I wanted to see, can you collect, if a campfire is on top of it, can you collect, if I put a drop on top of this, will it go in there? Really? So I could just use a bunch of hoppers for this? How much iron is that? So I could just use hoppers. I don't have to use hopper minecarts. That would require a lot of hoppers, but I guess, yeah, it just collects it just fine. Okay. Well, that's good to know. I don't think you get the campfire back, so that's disappointing, but it's okay. Okay. Yeah, I think we're just going to do the campfire method then. I think that's probably the best way to do this. And I think the campfire... Are there more slimes? I guess they're spawning in here. I guess that makes sense. It is a slime spawner. But it only works really good when I'm all the way up there. I'm trying to see on what layer I need to put them. But to be honest with you, since this is glass, I think you could just get away with putting them like right here. That should be more than okay. So yeah, that's what we're going to do. This is going to take quite a while to put all these hoppers down. Luckily, it's not as many hoppers as you'd think. It's still a good bit of hoppers, but it's not like a super, super ton of them, I guess. You know what? It's actually going to be quite a bit. I say that, but... Yeah, it's going to be quite a bit of hoppers, actually. I didn't even grab the rest of my campfires. I may have made a little bit too many of these campfire deals, but that's okay. That's okay. We'll find a use for them. I hadn't made any in this world yet. But yeah, we'll find a use for them. Okay. What are you doing? Okay. These need to go right here. Okay, so just give me a bit. I am going to fill in all of these. Ow, it fell on top of me. That's not fair. Okay, so I'm going to have to craft a bunch more hoppers than what I have. But the slimes are going to fall into these. I was going to do a hopper minecart, and then I looked into it, and I feel like they're just too complicated. Plus the smoke looks kind of cool. Okay, so what do we have for hoppers? Oh, we have 24. They were in my inventory. We have 24 hoppers. We're probably going to need a bunch more. Do I have any chests in here? No, but I do know where I have some chests. And I have a feeling I need to get... This is 3 by 16. So it's 48 hoppers times 2. So like 96 hoppers. Oh, yeah. I'm going to need a good bit. Hopefully I actually have enough stuff to make that many. Okay, maybe not. But we're going to go back to the base where I was smelting the rest of my iron. And let's find out if we can make 96 hoppers, because they take 5 iron each. So yeah, that's like 90 times 5. That's like 400. Why can't I do that? 9 times 5 is 45, right? Yeah. That's 450 iron. I don't know if I have that much. I'll be honest, but we're going to try our best. And if we can't, we'll go iron mining a little bit just so we can finish the slime farm this episode. This is going to be interesting. Next episode, we're going to be looking for a village. Don't know where one is because I've looked I even looked off camera and I still couldn't find one. So it's going to take quite a bit to find them, I feel, but it's going to be a fun little adventure. Hopefully you guys stick around for it. If you're not subscribed to my channel, I will encourage you to subscribe, you know, because I'm a YouTuber and this is my job and all. So I'd like to get more views, but if you feel as though I've earned your subscription, then please do subscribe. I'd love to see you on future videos. But if you don't want to, that's perfectly fine. Do what's going to make you happy. But if you feel like, oh my God, where do we have all this chest? If you feel like you want to watch more of me in the future, then please do subscribe. But again, don't feel like you have to, because you don't have to. Do what you want. Oh, it's all of our iron. All of our iron. All of our iron, all of our chests. No, dude. What have I done? What have I done? Oh, God. Every bit of iron we've mined now is made into hoppers. That's why people use hopper mine carts, because it takes significantly less iron. Isn't it? Isn't that the exact reason they do it? I think that's 104, so that's enough. We needed how many? We needed 96. We have 104. It's 8 extra hoppers. I feel like we're going to need a bit of extra, though. You know what? We're just going to try it with this, and if it doesn't work, it doesn't work. But we're going to see how many slimes we can get. I predict that this slime farm is going to be slightly overkill. Just slightly. Man, I've never made a slime farm. I've never made a slime farm before. It's like the first one I've ever made. So I was like, I really want to go, you know, I said that earlier. I want to go big or go home. But man, I really did go big. Way too big. Maybe a little overkill. I could have gotten away with maybe one platform. Maybe two. Nah, dude, that's not how we do it on this channel. I was going to build a little windmill and then I was designing it in my creative world and I was like, nope, doesn't look very good. And I never even designed the big one on a creative world. I just kind of made it. And why is there a creeper over here? You should not be able to spawn there. Oh, whatever. Okay, so now we just have to... Oh my goodness. It's already working, dude. It's already working, dude. Heck yes. I'm so happy, dude. I'm so happy. I don't know if you guys could tell. I'm so happy we have a slime farm. I know this is going to have to be rearranged a little bit, so I'm just going to preemptively do that. Because I'm going to have to fill this back in. Okay. And then we'll put the slabs back on top. Yeah, dude. I just hear them dying, falling and dying, falling and dying. Okay. Yeah, but actually, no. We can leave the torches down. It doesn't really matter. Okay, so I'm just going to do rows of hoppers running into each other. No. That's right. Hold on. We need to have these hoppers go this way. Wait. How do you do this again? How do you put hoppers that can build the giant, the biggest slime farm you've ever seen? And then he's like, how does this work again? Okay, the hoppers. They need to go into probably a good bit of chests. I just need to make a little area down here because it's going to take quite a bit of hoppers to do this. So I need to finesse a little bit of an area here that we can have to store our stuff, because otherwise we're just going to end up... Hey, well, there's some iron. Thanks for helping out. Okay, give me a little bit. I'm going to do... Actually, I'll do this one side on camera, and then we'll just copy it and do the other on another side. How about that? And we should probably just use some ladders, which we should have a good bit of. Unless I mistakenly threw them away. Yes, we do. And we still have trapdoors. Good, good, good. Okay. Okay. I'm going to try to sit all night in this spawner and see how many slimes we get, but I feel like it's just going to fill my inventory up. And also, I'm going to record right after this episode, so probably won't happen. But we're going to try it at some point. Maybe during the Zoom classes, we'll sit and see what happens. Okay, so chest. Wait, I should put them closer. I have to conserve my hoppers here. So chest, chest, and then hopper, hopper, and then wait. Why can't I do this? I just can't do it on camera. Give me a second. Okay, I figured it out. We're just going to do a simple... I don't know why that was so overwhelming for a second. I was like, I'm not going to be able to do this. And I'm also not going to have enough hoppers. I can just tell you right now. Based on the way that this has gone so far, definitely don't have enough hoppers. Okay, and then we'll just go up like right here because I don't want to... Is this... Sure. You know what? Sure. That's okay. We'll just have a temporary ladder right here. Not a biggie at all. Not a biggie at all. Nope, this does not even go up to the right area, but it's okay. It's all good. That's the whole reason I dug this underground thing, was to find slimes. That's the extremes I'll go to for you guys. Okay. Now everything should end up in here. There's already 40 slime balls in there. You know what? I take that back. We may have enough. We may have enough. Okay. Well, give me a bit. I'm going to do the same thing over on this side. Yeah, I'll show you what it looks like. We'll go sit up top and we'll see how many slimes we get. Hopefully it's a good bit. But yeah, basically what I did here is I dug out this little area. I'm thinking for myself here because I don't remember exactly what I did. It was something like this, right? I don't know. I can literally go right back over there and check though. It's not a big deal, you know, not a big deal at all. Just the biggest slime farm in all of the world. Not really. I'm sure you could build it bigger, but I don't know what the heck you'd need this many slimes for anyways, but you know what? We went for it. We really did go for it. Okay. So this chest was like right here. Okay. I can handle that. And then it was into the chest, over into the chest. You know what? That's different than the way I did it over there, but I think this way is way more efficient. And now we just have to place all of these. And I hope to God there's enough. Please tell me. Please be enough, dude. I don't want to go iron mining. I've done so much mining recently. That 2-hour live stream really was good. You guys should go back and check it out. I don't want you guys to feel like you ever miss any content, but it's just mining content. It's not super duper exciting anyways, so I feel like you didn't really miss much. Okay, so it should be complete. As long as I can get up somehow. Please help. Can I... Is this... Okay, you know what? Sure. It's fine. We'll have little construction entrances or something. Okay, so now we have both of the collection chambers done. Man. Okay, so we need to put slabs down in here. I don't even know why I dug this area out. We don't even need this area. I dug it out on the other side too, but I knew exactly where the chests were going to go. Why did I do that? The things I do sometimes, guys, I don't understand. But could you guys leave a like for all the effort I put into this slime farm? I really would appreciate it. I know you guys didn't get to see it, but I promise all you missed was me doing a lot of digging. And you know what? Maybe that was a bad idea. Maybe I should have shown it on camera, but I don't know. I don't really feel like you guys missed a whole ton. Did I? I'm so confused. That's basically my entire life, is just being confused. Okay. Yes. So there's already a stack of slime balls in there. I figured we'd need a lot of slime balls because to fill up this ant farm village is going to take probably like an inventory full of slime blocks. So I figured it would just be a good idea to go ahead and get a bunch. How does this path work? So it's 3 and then just down one. But how can it be like that? Oh, is there only a 1-block space on this side? No, there's 2-block. Wait. Oh, this isn't in the center. What? 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Oh. So these 2 blocks are the center then, eh? I said A. I'm not Canadian, dude. I'm from Oklahoma. Oklahoma. Okay. You know what? Sure. That's perfectly fine with me. We're gonna call it good there. That's fine. So there's a 2-block space there. Right? 2-block space for the chest. Okay. OCD is fulfilled. All right, so I'm going to go sit up top. We're going to see how many slimes we get. God, I can't believe I built this, dude. Oh, I can't believe I built this. Oh, no, it looks like there's a slime ball. If you can see it, it's just hidden right there. That's okay. I'm not really too concerned about that. Well, we're going to go sit up top. Let's sleep. Okay, good. It was night. So that means by the time I get back up, it will be perfectly time. Which I think there's still a construction entrance on one side. Again, it's not supposed to look pretty. It really is just the most rudimentary utilitarian slime farm you can make, but man, does it work. You can already hear it going ham. All right, well, I'm going to go sit up top. I'll meet you guys up there, and we'll talk for a second, and then we'll do a little bit of waiting and see what we get. I can't wait to get an elytra, dude. I need some wings so bad. But clearing out this giant area took forever. But as you guys can see, you see how they get sucked in towards the side? It's because they see the iron golem, and for some reason, they do not like iron golems. And they end up just jumping off the ledge unintentionally. But yeah, I'm going to climb all the way up here. I probably should put a bed up here. Because this is where I'll be sitting AFK, and if it becomes night, I'd like to sleep. But you guys can see the slime spawning in there. It took forever to light up all the caves around here. I had to dig little holes and like just kind of like, I don't know, basically like every like 10 blocks I'd dig a hole straight down until I fell into a cave. Very dangerous, I know, and then I'd just light up the whole cave. Yeah, you can see the campfires down there. You can see how the slimes are dying. The campfires don't burn the drops, they just burn the mob. And yeah, I'm going to sit up here for a bit and we'll see how well it works. You know what, guys? You actually get a very nice view up here. It's actually really cool. I've been waiting. It's been maybe 5 minutes. I'm honestly just so excited to see how much we're going to get. So I'm going to head back down real quick and I'll let you guys know the haul. Hopefully it's a good bit, but it's been like 5 minutes. So extrapolate that times 6 per hour. I hear the campfires are cooking. Cooking up some slime balls. Let's see what we got. I should have cut the camera quicker. I should have came back when I was closer, but we're gonna see. The suspense is real. The poor slimes giving their life. The poor slimes. They give their life for the screenshot. Oh my god! Dude, no way. Wait, what? Why is there so many more on this side? That's okay. I'm sure it'll even out eventually, but like, what? Dude, that's insane. Oh my god. So literally, like, if I said 5 minutes, that's how many we got. I'm trying to make sure all these hoppers are lined up correctly. Looks like they are. Looks like they're all good. Okay. People always ask me, Neo, how do you zoom in on Minecraft? And I'm like, you can't unless you're on Java and you install Optifine. And then you can zoom with the letter C on your keyboard. Super helpful. So let's just take some of these slime. Okay. Our construction chests, we don't need that anymore. We're not going to need this down here. We're going to bring that up. I'm going to throw up everything into here that I don't really need right now. We'll come back here and clean this chest up eventually. But for right now, it should be good like that. I am going to carry one trapdoor up there so I remember. And then we'll carry a bed. Water bucket 2 for MLG bucketing. I did do that a bunch on the stream. There was just a ton of fun stuff. Go check out the stream. I know I've said that like 3 times, but I really would appreciate it. Yes, slimes. Yes. Okay, we're going to gather all the slimes. We're going to see how many slime blocks that is. Because that's the whole goal here is to make slime blocks. I don't really care. The slime balls, whatever. I need slime blocks here, guys. That's what I need. Is there something clogging these chests? The hopper's not. Can I break this? Maybe. Yeah, it's going into there. I don't know. Maybe it's just a little bit slower than the other one. That's okay. All right, let's see how many slime blocks this is, because I feel like it's a good bit. We need to go to where there is a crafting table. Yeah, we could grab the rest of our slime balls as well out of this chest, and then we'll see how many we have. So it may take a good bit of farming. I'd like to record the episodes one after another. I can't believe we have that many diamonds, though, dude. Like, that's nice. That's really nice. So we can just throw them in here like that. So that's a stack. So yeah, it is going to take quite a bit. Can you make them back into the balls? Cool. Okay. Well, for the screenshot, I'm going to need to have a double chest full of them. So I'll probably just stack one from the other chest into the other one. But yeah, that's the slime farm. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. And if you did, I would really appreciate it if you left a like, but you don't have to. Do what you want. But if you want to show your appreciation for all the effort that went into this bad boy, then leave a like. And if you're new to the channel and you want to see more of me, you like the content you're seeing, then click the subscribe button and turn on post notifications. That way you actually know when I upload. In the pinned comment, the top comment down there by me is a link to my official Discord server, which are where I send out like stream notifications and stuff like that. So even if you don't have post notifications on and you just want to be in the Discord server to talk or whatever, or if you want to get live stream notifications, that's going to be your best bet. I don't know why that's the case. I wish that wasn't the case. But honestly, if you don't like join the Discord server, like for some reason when I start live streaming, it doesn't send out notifications to everyone, because I have like a whole group of people I ask every time. And it seems to be about like 50 to 60% get live stream notifications. Like, what's that? 50 to 60% of my notification viewers are only getting the notifications? What? YouTube, what are you doing? So join the Discord if you want 100% of the chance to see the live streams. Because I don't live stream super often. I don't know what I'm going to live stream next on this. Jeez, dude. I can't handle the stress. I could MLG bucket down there, but I'm afraid I would die if I missed it, so I'm just not going to do it. I could do an MLG bucket from up here. No, I'm not going to do it. I'm not going to do it. That's too stressful, guys. I don't want to put myself or you guys through that. But yeah, we're going to put a trap door up here. Just I don't know if something could climb all the way up here, but you know what? I'm not even going to risk it. We're not even going to risk it. We're going to throw this down there because I'm going to be sitting up here for a good bit. Where can I even put the bed? maybe I should have brought more trapdoors. I guess I could put the bed right there, but then I want to like sit. I want to sit like in the center, so I can hold down shift maybe. Can I get up on top of the bed, please? Plus, no. Is there nowhere else I can put this bed? I literally don't think there's anywhere else to fit it in here. No. The only spot would be if I put more trapdoors, I could put it in the corner over here if I move these doors as well. You know what? It'll just go right there. I'm sure the amount of efficiency I lose by being one block off is not anything to be concerned with. But yes, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next episode. Look how beautiful our world is, guys. We've been making big moves on the hardcore world, honestly. This has been an incredible time. I really have loved every second of this hardcore world. I'm so excited for the Caves and Cliffs update too. But yeah, I'm going to sit up here before recording the next episode so I can get enough slime balls for the thumbnail. But yeah, I will see you guys in tomorrow's episode, episode 17. Thank you so much for watching. Again, subscribe if you want to. Leave a like on the video if you haven't already. And yeah, I'll see you tomorrow. Bye. Psych! I ended the video, but I've been waiting. I've been watching YouTube. Funny, because I'm recording for YouTube. I've been watching YouTube for like 20 minutes, maybe something like that. So we're going to check out how many slimes we got. Okay, it was just now becoming night. Oh, well, I guess it's only been 10 minutes. Sorry, I misled you guys, but I'll meet you guys down in the farm. We'll see how much we got. Oh, I hear the slimes. I hear the slimes. They're slopping and glopping. Let's go check out our stuff. How much did we get? I'm really hoping. I did the math. This should be 3,000 per hour around there. Maybe a little bit above, a little bit below because of RNG. But you can see they'll just like fall. Just straight in. Let's see the chest. Oh my god. Maybe I should have put more chests. What the heck? Okay, maybe something's wrong with this side. How can it favor one side more than the other? Are they getting stuck somewhere? I don't see any slime balls on the ground. Oh, did we put all the slime balls back into this chest? We did, didn't we? I'm an idiot. So this is how many slime balls we should get then from like 10 minutes. However many that may be. But yeah, thank you guys for watching. I figured I'd show you a little bit more. I'm going to wait a little bit more. I may show you guys again how much we get. So keep in mind, we're not going to look at that chest. When we do the calculations, we're going to be looking at this chest. But yeah, I'll meet you guys back. I'm going to wait like 20 minutes and see what we get. All right, well, it's been about 10 minutes, so let's just see what we got. There we go. So right around in line with what we got last time. That's quite a bit of slime balls, dude. We're going to have so many. This chest is literally already full. Oh, God. Well, that's exactly what I need for the thumbnail. I just need this exact picture. Boom. We're done. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed getting to see how well this thing works. It's literally insane. Like, literally insane. We never are going to use this many, but at least we have the means to gather them, I suppose. I don't even have a crafting table over here. That's what I need to bring. Maybe I have one. Do I have some? Do I have any wood in here? Really? None? Okay, we'll go make some slime balls. We'll see how much a double chest gives us. But we're going to need quite a bit. I realize now we may not be able to make the ant farm village this weekend just because I'm going to have to grind a lot and I like to record these all in a row. I set aside one day of the week I like to work. If I do it more than that, I get scheduling conflicts with homework and it just doesn't work out. So that's why I do it like that. Not because I'm lazy, but because I'm a full-time student in college and I care about my education a little bit. Right. Okay, so I'm going to go. That's only. Oh, I thought it was only 37. So it's two stacks and they're somewhat translucent too. It's going to look really cool having an ant farm of these. Like, you know what I mean? It's like that blue gel stuff that you see in like your common ant farms. You can go on Google Images and look up a picture of an ant farm. And it's usually that blue gel. You know what I didn't grab? I literally walked all the way over there and did not grab a crafting table. Okay, well, I'll see you guys in tomorrow's episode, episode 17. Bye. Ha, gotcha again. Psych, I just grabbed two crafting tables. I said I was going to show you how much you get from waiting this long, so I figure I'll be a man of my word here. We're going to put crafting table. Oh, that's not. Trust me, I'd never leave it like that. Never do that to you guys. Okay, grab all the slimes out of here. It works okay when you're down here, but it really does work just miles better when you're all the way at the top. Just because you're so close, I don't know the exact science behind it, if there is science behind it, but let's see. How many slime blocks? Or what are they called? Yeah, slime blocks. How many slime blocks is it? Sure, we can make one more. Okay, so like less than 30 minutes. Probably about 30 minutes, maybe a little bit less. Maybe like 25, 20. Got us that many. I think we're in a good position here. I really do. Okay. Well, thank you guys for watching. And I guess we can put a little bit of chest storage like right over here where we can store some of the slime balls or something like that. Can't really hurt us to have a little bit of slime ball storage. Slime block storage, my bad. That's so nice, dude. I cannot believe I made something like this. I've never had any like mega slime farms before, but looks like we finally did it, guys. We finally did it. Anyways, I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye for the final time.